Good morning to all. Now we will discuss about the minimum mode of 8086. Normally we have two modes of operation, minimum mode and maximum mode. For selecting minimum mode, you have to put one at the minimum and maximum pin of the 8086 processor. For selecting maximum mode, you have to put 0 at the minimum and maximum pin of the 8086 processor. Normally 8088 and 8086 are similar for the selection of mode features. In minimum mode, you can use only one processor. In maximum mode, you can use the many processor. For selecting minimum mode of 8086 processor, you have to put 1 at the minimum and maximum pin of the 8086 processor, which means you have to connect VCC to the minimum and maximum pin of the 8086 processor. Next, you have to connect the external clock generator. Because you don't have an internal clock generator, that's why we are connecting the external clock generator. Next one is the memory and input and output pin, which is used to decide the whether the data to be transferred to memory or input and output devices. The read write pins are used to decide the whether the data to be read or write. Next one is the latches. When ALE pin is enabled, the latches demultiplexes the address from multiplexed address and data line. After it sends the address to the external address bus. Next one is the transceiver. When DEN is enabled, the transceiver demultiplexes the data from multiplexed address and data line. Afterwards, it transfers the data to the external data bus. Here, for minimum mode, you have to select one for minimum and maximum pin of the 8086 processor. This is the single processor. We have remaining elements are latches, transceiver, clock generator, memory and input and output devices. We have also external clock generator, which is used to pulse the external signal. We have the 20 address line and 16 data lines. Latches are buffered output D flip-flops, which is used to separate the valid address from multiplex address and data signal, which is controlled by the ALE. When ALE is enabled, the latches are separate the valid address from multiplex address and data signal. Transceivers are bidirectional buffers. Sometimes they are called as the data amplifier, which is used to separate the valid data from the multiplex address and data signal. We have two signals, namely DEN and DT by R. When DEN is enabled, the transceiver separates the valid data from multiplexed address and data signal. DT by R is used to select whether the data to be transferred or received. Now we are seeing the read cycle for 8086 processor. Normally we have the four pulses T1, T2, T3, T4. During T1, ALE is enabled. When ALE is enabled, latches separates the address from the multiplex address and data line. During T1, A92, A16 are selected. From T2 to T4, S7 to S3 are selected. S7 and S3 are status pins. During T1, A16 or A0 are selected. Afterwards, the data are demultiplexed from multiplex address and data lines. The read bar equal to 0, which is selected from T2 to T4 pulses. When DEN equal to 0, which is selected from T2 pulses to T4 pulses. Next, DT by R bar is equal to 0. Here the receiver is selected from T1 pulses to T4 pulses. Next one is the write cycle for 8086 processor. Normally we have 4 cycle, T1, T2, T3, T4. We already know that. When ALE is enabled, the latches separate the address from multiplex address and data lines. When during T1, the A19 to A16 are selected. Afterwards, during T2 to T4, the S7 to S3 are selected, which are status lines. During T1, A16 to A0 selected. Afterwards, the data are demultiplexed from the multiplex address and data line. When WR bar equal to 0, which is selected from T2 pulse to T4 pulses. When DEN bar equal to 0, which is selected from T2 bar pulses to T4 pulses.